Hello, GitHub Universe 2020 attendees. Welcome to the Microsoft Virtual Booth. My name is Abel, Principal Cloud Advocate and DevOps Lead at Microsoft. Now, all of us at Microsoft, we hope y'all are staying safe at home and doing well in these difficult times. Community is what GitHub is all about. And while we can't be with you in person, we still want to connect with you. So please visit our virtual booth, join our Discord channel and upcoming AMAs to chat with me and also other devs at Microsoft. We also want to hear about your Microsoft Virtual Booth experience. So please tell us more in our survey. And if you do, you get a chance to win one of $250 Adafruit gift cards, which you can use towards a Raspberry Pi or some other super cool IoT device. Okay, on to the fun stuff. Look, we all know GitHub is a place where developers live. And at Microsoft, we love GitHub. In fact, you say GitHub, I immediately think of two things, Visual Studio Code and Azure. VS Code is a phenomenal code editor for any language that is perfect for GitHub and development work. And Azure is the ultimate cloud for GitHub. Let me show you what I mean. VS Code seamlessly integrates into GitHub with extensions created by GitHub and the VS Code team. Now, from within VS Code, you can update your repos, do your pull requests, work with your issues, and configure your GitHub actions. Now, as a dev, being able to do all this without ever leaving VS Code is freaking awesome. And when you're ready to ship your code, Azure becomes the ultimate cloud for GitHub. I can sign into Azure using my GitHub account, and once in, Azure has everything you need, from all sorts of flavors of VMs to all kinds of databases to Kubernetes. And again, Azure has what you need. So let's harness the power of Azure and start building amazing apps. Now, once you're in Azure, working with Azure is simple too. In VS Code, we've got extensions for all things Azure. And with these extensions, you can right-click and publish, configure resources, all the way to even debugging your app running in Azure. And you get to do all this from within VS Code. Now, we've also made it extremely easy to take the code that lives in your repository and deploy it into Azure by harnessing the power of GitHub Actions. Actions is GitHub's workflow engine, where you can automate just about anything inside of GitHub, including workflows to build and deploy your app. Right now, there are over 50 GitHub Actions built by the Azure teams for all your CI/CD scenarios, ranging from simple app deployments all the way to triggering complex compliance scans with Azure. And finally, everyone's been telling us they want the getting started experience to be easy. And guess what? We listened. Now we have GitHub accelerators, which are GitHub templates that make going from nothing at all to everything you need in your GitHub repo to code running in Azure ridiculously simple. And by using these templates, you get sample code in your repository in the language of your choice. You get build and release pipelines using GitHub Actions that automatically provision and configures what you need in Azure, all the way to building and deploying your app into those resources. So you wanted an easy way to get started? Well, bam, here it is. All right, let's check out the Node example. We'll use the Node template, so we'll give this a name. And if we use this template, what happens is it generates for me everything I need in my repo to get started inside of Azure. Now, underneath the applications folder is my sample Node app. And as you can see, this is just a plain Jane vanilla Node.js application. And underneath the .github/workflows folder, here we have workflows that provision and configure the resources I need in Azure, as well as build and deploy my app. There are also workflows for pull requests and workflows for setting security policies in Azure as well. So again, I can now literally start from nothing at all to my app running in Azure with almost no effort. Come here, check this out. This is my Azure subscription. And as you can see, it's completely empty. So let's jump back to our repo. We'll touch a file and let's see what happens. And let's go ahead and touch my README file. So this is my README file. Let's scroll to the end. I'll go ahead and add a space. Let's commit my changes. And as soon as my code hits the master branch, it kicks off our automation. And what's the automation doing? Let's take a look and see. First, it's going to build and test my app. And in parallel, it's going to go ahead and provision the infrastructure I need up in Azure. And when it's done building my app and provisioning the infrastructure, it'll take the bits that I just built and deploy it into the infrastructure I just provisioned. Now, this takes a little bit of time to complete. So while this is working, let's look and see exactly what's going on. If we go into our YAML file, we'll see a couple of jobs, right? First is the build job that builds and tests this Nodes app, and it packages everything up so it's ready to be deployed. In parallel, we have a provision job that provisions the infrastructure we need up in Azure by using ARM templates. And the ARM templates are included in this repository. Now, when both the build and the provision jobs are done, then we do the deploy job that takes the bits that we just built and deploys it into the infrastructure that we just provisioned. And finally, we have a functional test job, which is a placeholder to run your functional tests in the environment that was just created. All right, let's take a look and see what's going on with our workflow. We'll click on the Actions tab. Looks like everything's done. All the jobs are green. Fantastic. We jump into Azure. Let's refresh. Here's a new resource group, and inside of here are all the resources that were provisioned, including this Azure App Service that will host our application. We'll go ahead and click on the URL, and bam, check that out. There's my sample app running in Azure. So now, if you want your Node.js app to run in Azure, just drop your code into the Applications folder, kick back and relax while GitHub Actions gets triggered and takes care of everything for you. All right, one last thing. People are always worried about costs, right? Well, there are a ton of low-cost or even free services for developers to take advantage of. For instance, this demo you just saw, it's running on the free tier of Azure App Service. And in the future, if we need more power, we can easily scale up and also scale out. All right, everyone. VS Code, GitHub, and Azure, they form the dream team that empowers GitHub developers to build the apps they love, the way they want, and deploy it where they want. So thanks again for checking out our Microsoft Virtual Booth. Make sure you fill out our survey so you get a chance to win one of $250 Adafruit gift cards. And man, I can't wait to hear about all the cool IoT devices you get. And don't forget to join our Discord channel and our AMAs as well. And if you have any questions for me, join my AMA December 10th at 5:30 Pacific. Thanks, everyone.